Hello, I'm Mr. R. Nitya, a retired lecturer in metallurgy teaching Christianity and Sikhism. Here I represent Hajj Part 16, the third form of real Satan, inciting people in the name of God or religion, which is called Al-Djmar Al-Aksa, are the most powerful hypocrite sons of Satan. In fact, the greedier the rabbis became, farther apart they went from God and got themselves entangled in the fog of the night, which is the falsehoods, best clarified in the light of sun. So you remember, if at night we get fog, when the sun appears in the morning, the fog disappears. But if you love night and you don't love God, then this fog will intensify and will entangle you. So the light of sun is the gospel truth, as I will do. I'm explaining it. So this gospel truth is not liked by the hirelings of Mammon. You go to these temple churches in the town, nobody likes you, because you speak the gospel truth, which is of God and not of the Mammon. Mammons speak hypocrisy. So, if you remember, I did the exposition of the menorah, the candle farthest apart from God is the one which is the hypocrites, these represent. The nearest to the God on the left hand side are the fanatic sons of Satan, who do things wrong unknowingly. So that's why Saint Stephen was praying for them to God, and so Saul was one of them, but God had mercy on him and made him to come join with him. Thus, at the end of training, a person is supposed to have the knowledge of God in spirit, or the oral Torah. So when somebody trained you, in like Saul was trained by Gamaliel, you should have knowledge of the oral Torah as well as the written scriptures. But Gamaliel himself was devoid of the light of God. So he produced stubborn, once-born fanatics, drunk with the old wine of corrupted scriptures. Remember, Jesus said the old cross dwelt holes, and we can patch them, or with the we can make it the cloth whole with the knowledge of the oral Torah or the gospel truth. Jerusalem temple, the university of theology, was the wine press that was supposed to produce good quality scriptures, the old wine, but the corruptions led to poor quality old wine that Jesus came to improve upon its quality by explaining to them the very spiritual basis of their moral laws. But they, being drunk with the old wine of letters, desired not the new, and killed him for his interference in their crooked business. For killing him without any wrongdoing, as one of the two robbers proclaimed, the accusers were bundled up in Israel and were killed mercilessly, worse than the killing of the people of Sodom and Gomorrah. Remember when the Roman had a great siege of the temple, Jerusalem, in 66 AD. Not a single just man was left there. St. James the Just was killed, and all the just people had left Jerusalem. So what the leftover was worse than the people of the Sodom and Gomorrah. So they all were killed because of the hypocrisy of these blind guides, hypocrite. The temple priests themselves knew that Jesus is the Son of God, but they won't tell the other people in case they lose their business. No one but they themselves are to be blamed for the holocausts, one after the other. So all these holocausts that took place during this temple siege, and the other one in Germany and in England and all that, nobody, you can't blame anyone else, because this is the age of Christ. In Christ, everyone has to give his own account to God. So if they are led by the blind guides, and they followed them, so they are to be blamed for being killed. I know it's a very bad thing, as in during partition, so many people got killed because the hypocrite leaders, they led them to partition. So these things will happen in this world, and today you can see in Israel, all the people are fighting with each other. They are both led by the blind guides. I will explain that one later. So such religious moral teachers who were supposed to be leading a lifestyle of people living in the wilderness, owing no secular property, mostly being themselves not spiritually blind, as the temple priest identified that Jesus is the very Son of God. So the temple priest, when Christ Jesus uttered the last parable on his visit, the parable of wine press, the temple priest knew that he is pointing the finger at us. And so they wanted to catch him. So they knew that he is the anointed Christ who has come to take account of the wine press. But they hypocritically misled their once-born stooges for the sake of their own praises, authority, and mammon, that they perished during the great siege when the temple was destroyed forever. So during the great siege, they paid for the hypocrisy and for killing Christ Jesus. Imagine how many millions of people died during the temple siege and other holocaust caused by these hypocrite rabbis and these hypocrite messianic Jews. They created a greater havoc and blindness. No one else is to be blamed than those hypocrite temple priests, the form of Satan called Al-Djmar Al-Aksa, the Satan that exploited the once-born stupid people in the name of religion and gets them killed. So Al-Djmar Al-Aksa, as you know, this mosque in Jerusalem is called Al-Masjid Al-Aksa. So that is where I think was the holiest of holy temple, and where this mosque is built now. And if you take measurement of that and compare it with the measurement of the Golden Temple in Amritsar, they should be similar, because Amritsar Golden Temple is the replacement of this Jerusalem Temple, holiest of holy. So, but it is more corrupt than anyone else. The fanatics are the stooges, are the mountains of fanatics, led by their colorfully dressed Satan, leaning against the support of the mountain of fanatics. Remember that this Al-Djmar Al-Aksa is leaning against a mountain. But these fanatic, or this Al-Djmar Al-Aksa, is he who reads the last lesson after in Kaaba. So he has removed that a hill, and he had put a statue instead, a pillar over there, which is wrong. So this was done because the people are blind, spiritually blind. So this Al-Djmar Al-Aksa, he has the mountain of fanatics, and that's what Saint Stephen blamed that sorry, I will do the next one.